Hi, this is Rachel from TLC Inspirations, and today we're going to do something a little bit different. I'm going to show you the basics of needle felting or dry felting. And for that, we need a nice thick piece of foam, and we need a needle for needle felting, which you can usually pick up at any craft center, fiber store, anything like that. And they usually, sometimes we'll sell them in a starter kit, pretty inexpensive. And then we're going to need wool roving, and roving is just yarn that hasn't been spun yet, but it is wool, which will be easiest to felt into this piece of craft wool, which is, I'm just going to show you little samples using the craft wool. You can also needle felt yarn as well. I suppose we can go ahead and get started. I'm going to use this blue roving here. And I'm just gonna pull off a little bit. And you don't need much. It's better to use a little bit and then keep adding the wool roving to like fill in the spaces than it is to use too much. So I'm just gonna do a little, we're just gonna do a little tuft of it here. And so you wanna kinda mold it. We're gonna mold it into a little circle. And we're gonna keep our fingers away from the needle. This is a barbed needle. It hurts going in and it hurts coming out, and it's also very delicate. So you wanna keep your needle going in and out perfectly up and down and straight. You do not wanna tilt it because it will break. And you will end up going through a lot of needles if you keep doing that. So let's do this. Put the roving where you want it. And then just start poking it in. We're trying to blend the fibers. So what the barbed needle does is intertangle the fibers of both the craft felt and the wool roving. And you'll see that once we get a little further along here, you'll see that it'll start to show through the back of the craft felt. And you'll see these little blue fibers starting to puff out the back. That's a good sign that you're doing the right thing. Now I can already see I've got a little light colored spot. Right about here. So I'm just gonna pull a tiny bit of roving and I'm just gonna lay it right in that spot. And you can see as you work this in, you can definitely tell that the fibers are getting pulled in. They're getting sucked in and they will start tightening up. Now I'm not using a scooping motion, but you can see I'm kind of using the needle to drag a few little stray fibers in. It's perfectly normal, and when you start to do shaping and such, you'll find yourself doing that a lot. We're not going to really worry about shaping anything right now. We just want to get to the heart of the matter here, and that is the felting. The other benefit of using the wool roving is once you're done felting, you can felt it a little bit further by using a hot steamy iron over it with a press cloth or something so you don't scorch the top of your project that you're working on. Okay, so you can see starting to come along, and you can see that it's kind of indented going in here because the fibers are being pushed so hard into this. We have to kind of peel it out of the foam. Those are all the fibers going through the craft felt into the foam. And that's okay, it slides out really easily, but you can see we've got a nice big puff of fuzz back here. That means the fibers are intertwining, which is great. I'm gonna work on it a little bit more, flatten it out a little bit more, keeping my fingers away. The longer you felt, the tighter it gets, the more interwoven it becomes. So it's really up to you when you wanna stop, but you do want it to be secure. I think that's gonna do it for me. Okay, so you can see that it's woven into the fabric pretty well. Can see a little bit of tiny holes. Once I run the iron over it though, it will smooth everything out and it will actually felt up a little bit more. It'll look real nice. Okay, so next, white yarn. Yarn is a little trickier only because it's so small. So it's kind of hard to hit with the needle and it will have a tendency to roll. If you want to do it in like a swirl or zigzag design, I recommend kind of tacking it first. So I'm going to tack it down right here and do a couple slow ones right here. And that will kind of hold it in place temporarily. And then I'm going to go up here. Watch your fingers, watch your fingers. Okay, so I've kind of tacked it there. And then I'm going to tack it down here. Just to show you that you can kind of hold it in one place so it's not so complicated when you're doing like freeform. Okay, so let's felt this bad boy. And it's okay, you'll watch your needle kind of bounce over it. It'll take some practice before you're able to kind of keep it on the yarn itself. The other thing about needle felting is it's very forgiving. So if you're doing something and you decide that you just don't like it, pull it off. Because here we go, you can see I haven't felted this part yet. It's not attached. This part I have, but look. If I don't like the placement or I didn't like how it turned out, you can just pull it out and start over. So not a big deal. See that? Pull out your little threads. Start all over. And they are now making molds for needle felting, which I think is really great, but it really only works for flat surfaces. So if you want to do like a perfect little polka dot or a little ball, let's try that first. I know I've got one in here for that somewhere. Here we go. Okay, so right here, let's zoom out here. So we can see right here in the corner, I've got one just for a little circle. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my needle and just kind of push it into the mold without hurting myself. And then hold it in place. And you're gonna do the same thing, only you're gonna do it inside a mold. Keeping your needle straight up and down. Once you've got it kind of packed in there a little bit, you should be able to remove the mold. You can see how lovely my polka dot is. Look at that. I'm just gonna needle felt it further, flatten it out a little bit, get it a little more bound to the fiber. I'd say that's looking pretty good. A little blue polka dot. So it keeps its shape a little bit better. You can freeform those pretty easily, but sometimes it's nice to have a mold on a flat surface, like if you're doing a bag or something like that. You can also use stencils that you just cut out, something you print out on the internet and then cut out. One way is, this is a little mitten, and I use this on a Christmas ornament, and I used this to outline in yarn, and then just filled it when I was done with roving. You can also use this part of it, and don't do the outline at all, and just slowly, I'd pin this down and just fill it with roving and use your needle and just needle felt that puppy right in there. So there are a lot of ways to do this, and I have a Christmas project coming up using some of these methods, so please check it out. And thank you so much for watching.